Now let's have a look at this program File Copy Timer. So File Copy Timer will try different ways to copy a 15 megabyte file and measure how long time it takes. So it's very good practice to write such a program. It's one thing to read the documentation and see which method is supposed to be fastest, but it's very good practice to also try it in practice, as this program does. Also, the program illustrates how to code the different methods for file access. So let's have a look at this program. The first method to copy data is to use the stream-based API and just read byte by byte, one byte at a time. So this is byte-based copy using the stream-based API. So open input stream from the file that is copied, output stream to the file we are copying to, and read one byte at a time and write that byte. Next method is to use reader-writer API, character-based API, but still copying one byte at a time. Instead of file input stream and file output stream, we use file reader and file writer. Read one byte at a time and write that byte to the out file. Third method, still using the reader-writer API, but now we use the buffered reader and the print writer, which means we can copy one line at a time instead of one byte. Read up the next new line and then print that thing. So we read one line at a time and print that line. And the lines in this file are pretty short. The lines are simply contain the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Next method, buffered reader API. So here we use again buffered reader and print writer, but now we handle entire buffers. The buffer length is 1496 bytes, characters, and that is because a character in Java is 2 bytes long, so this is 8192 bytes, and that's the default size of the buffer in the buffered reader. So we are using the entire buffer of buffered reader. I mean, in each read we empty the buffer of buffered reader. Fill the buffer, write the buffer content to the out file. Then the same thing using the stream-based API, now buffered input stream and buffered output stream. Size is now 8192, because now we are using bytes instead of characters. So again, use the entire buffer size in the buffered streams. Okay, so those were the Java IO methods. Then come the Java NIO methods. So first thing is to use not a direct buffer, so allocate a buffer of the same size, 8192 bytes. Read from the in channel, which is connected to the input stream. Flip, which means prepare for writing. Write to the out channel, which is connected to the output stream. Clear, which means empty the buffer before reading again, filling it the next time. Okay, then the same thing using the direct NIO API, exactly the same code as in previous copying method, but now we use allocate direct instead of allocate. And last, the transfer API. So here we use transfer to from in channel to out channel, which hopefully means that the file content is copied in the disk cache of the operating system. Yeah, those are the different methods, and in the main method, just call these different methods, and each method will return the number of milliseconds it took to copy the file. So let's run it. Actually, I have already run it, because there are some quite surprising results, which means it takes a long time to run it. First, these three lines are the reader-writer API. Byte-based is slower than line, which is in turn is slower than buffers, using buffers. That makes sense. The more we can read in at one, the same time, the faster it is. Then comes a very surprising result. These two lines are the stream-based API. So we see that, okay, byte-based stream API is slower than buffer-based stream API. It makes sense, but why is it so immensely slow? That's a very good question, and we can mainly just speculate. But I did try to run the profiler to see where it spends the time. So here are the profiler results. So main method, and we are considering the stream based API. So we can see it spends the time here in the write method, not in the read method, which is relatively fast. Okay, what happens in there? Well, it's the native method, the operating system call, that takes time. It spends 91.8% of the total execution time of the entire program is spent in the native write method. Okay, we could of course try to find the source code for this native method, but that's platform dependent, so I give up at this point. I have not looked at that code. One thing is that just making the 15 million system calls to the operating system is of course not a very good idea, but on the other hand, also the character based reader writer API makes at least 7.5 million calls, since it handles 2 bytes at the same time. Okay, back to the measurements. So then we see here the NIO results that are generally fast compared to the IO results, and the order is the expected. The indirect method is slightly slower than the direct method, and the fastest is the transfer method. But the difference is not very big between transfer and the direct IO. Could be platform dependent somehow, or maybe the file is still too small to show the difference. But 15 megabytes should be enough. Okay, but anyway, this is the fact. Could be that we get a different result if we do the copying several times and take the average. This is just the time of one single copying. Another slightly surprising result might be that the buffer-based stream API is so fast. It's actually as fast as the direct NIO method and almost as fast as the transfer NIO method. But it could be that this stream-based buffer somewhere under the hood actually uses the NIO API. I think that's quite a reasonable assumption. If there exists a very fast way to handle file access, why shouldn't at least one of the Java IO APIs use that fast method? Okay, so interesting result. This is actually good practice to write such a program that compares the time of different operations.